Whether you're a Republican or independent and a few Democrats, you want a nation that the law and order applies to all Americans fairly.
It's about time, brother.
Justice system in New York and the DOJ continues to make President Trump into a victim.
Oh, hell no. This all started this week when an appeals court slashed Donald Trump's original $454 million bond by more than two-thirds to $175 million in his New York civil fraud lawsuit, which was a tragic result for comedy fans everywhere who yearned to see a man once convicted of housing discrimination against black people get his property seized by a black woman. I mean, how could you? How could you? That kind of irony don't just pop up every day. I mean, maybe if the feds raiding Diddy's properties are yelling, take that, take that, take that, take that. But by the way, that makes him the first person I've ever heard just get their bond slashed just because, I guess, going to the news and claiming to be broke really does have its benefits. It's not all about child support. Now, we may still get a chance to see it, though, so stay tuned. Letitia James may have her day in the sun, but the reduced bond offers him a financial lifeline, given that he claimed not to have the cash on hand to cover the original amount. What? That can't be right. He always bragging about how rich.
I love other people's money.
Ah, now I get it. Still, that's fortunate, because you never know where he might get that money.
Is there any effort on the part of your team to secure this money through another country, Saudi Arabia or Russia, as Joy Behar seems to think?
Well, there's rules and regulations that are public. I can't speak about strategy.
No, I don't do that. I think you'd be allowed to, possibly. I don't know.
I love other people's money.
The decision sets the stage for Trump's criminal trial, scheduled to begin on April 15th in New York.
Well, you pointed out he's also said, respect to the court, he will do what he is told to do. And you think that works for him?
I do, and I think it's significant because it's in contrast to what many members of the Democrat Party do, which is say, I'm not complying, Hunter Biden. The Supreme Court justices are off their rocker, President Biden. Right? We have a lot of examples of people who disrespect the court when they disagree with their ruling. President Trump is not one of them.
Who gonna tell her?
Respect the appellate division for substantially reducing that ridiculous amount of money that was put on by a corrupt judge named Ngoron. He ought to be looked at, seriously looked at, especially what he did with valuations. He's the one, he's a fraudulent valuator.
Because it's a setup, it's a rigged trial. We have a hostile group of people. We have a very hostile judge.
How long has her cable been cut off?
Like, I have the worst judge in the whole country, and I have a trial going on, a fake trial, a totally fake trial. And we asked the judge if I could take a day off for a funeral of my mother-in-law, who was very close to me also. And he said, no. Can you imagine? These are animals.
But I also knew we have a corrupt judge. He's not a respected man.
Yes, they deserve to die, and I hope they burn in hell.
Oh, maybe what she meant was he didn't disrespect the judge today, right? That's MAGA logic. If it's not happening right now, this moment, then it doesn't exist. What is it? Nighttime there? Ain't no sun. Ain't no sun. It doesn't exist. Fake news.
Businesses are fleeing and crime is flourishing all over the state, and what he's done is such a disservice and should never be allowed to happen again.
And there it is.
But Judge Ngoron is a disgrace to this country. We have a judge who I believe is a crooked judge and a crooked attorney general. Absolutely crooked.
Couldn't help himself. He couldn't help himself. He's like an addict.
This is a pure case of voter intimidation and election interference.
I'm sorry. Did he say election interference? You mean like this?
We've now learned that there was this big effort by the former administration, of senior people in the former administration, to interfere with the vote counts on the state level.
Or like this.
Now it is up to Congress to confront this egregious assault on our democracy. And after this, we're going to walk down, and I'll be there with you. We're going to walk down. Anyone you want, but I think right here we're going to walk down to the Capitol.
Or like this. Okay, go on.
If this was a case could have been brought 3.5 years ago, and they decide to wait now, just during the election, so that I won't be able to campaign, I will be appealing this.
Yeah, you can't appeal this, but I know that you'll try, just like how you're trying to convince everybody that you're a victim of a two-tier justice system.
I think the bigger concern here, though, is the two-tiered system of justice.
This is manifest injustice. It is impossible. It's an impossibility. I believe they knew that. I think everything is done intentionally. I do not doubt that the witch hunt, that the election interference goal is what was ringing steady and loudly and true throughout all these trials, frankly. And we're seeing it. It's the demise of our country, not the demise of Trump.
Justice system in New York and the DOJ continues to make President Trump into a victim. And whether you're a Republican or independent and a few Democrats, you want a nation that the law and order applies to all Americans fairly. And we are watching with our own eyes.
Ah, yes, the two-tier justice system, because who among us hasn't walked around free on bond with 91 cases under their belt? I don't know a single person. Well, maybe Diddy. Maybe Diddy could have walked around with 91 cases.
He did that shit. Guilty as fuck.
Now, in addition to all of the credible SA allegations that he's out from under, look, we would have been in jail just from the Access Hollywood tape.
You know, I'm automatically attracted to beautiful. I just start kissing them. It's like a magnet. I just kiss. I don't even wait. And when you're a star, they let you do it.
And I don't mean being caught on the Access Hollywood tape. I thought I would get arrested just from listening to the Access Hollywood tape. A two-tier justice system is half a squadron showing up to accost Eric Garner for selling Lucy cigarettes, him losing his life, and nobody being held accountable for it, except for, of course, the citizens of New York, by and large, who objected to the way the whole thing was handled. A two-tier justice system is Kalief Browder sitting in jail without being convicted of a crime. Why don't we look at how many people in New York State are sitting in jail not being convicted of a crime to pressure them into taking a plea? Well, how about your boy Rudy Giuliani and the stop and frisk? Speaking of a two-tier justice system, which was focused on black and brown citizens. How about Crystal Clanton, you know, the law clerk just hired by Clarence Thomas, who had her text leak where she said, "I hate black people, F them, all of them." Yeah, she worked on cases involving black defendants, and those defendants won't get their cases reopened because Clarence Thomas said so. That's a two-tier justice system. How about the state of Mississippi and District Attorney Doug Evans systematically excluding black jurors? Oh, the fact that those convicted stayed in jail for years before this was even uncovered, or that the man in charge will have little to no punishment for playing with people's lives and freedom. Thanks for playing, Doug. This is what a two-tiered justice system looks like. But don't get it twisted what tier you're on, because Donnie, if you were on the other tier, we wouldn't be seeing an impromptu press conference. We would be reading letters.
And a lot of people said that that's why the black people like, because they have been hurt so badly and discriminated against.
Well, where was this when we were in the streets begging for justice and you were talking about law and order?
And we'll bring crime back to law and order. We're going to get those words law and order back.
And you're still there talking about law and order, you know, when you're not in front of us.
And if I were not running, or if I were doing poorly like everyone else has done, because they're all gone, they're all knocked out except for crooked Joe Biden, if I were doing poorly, this wouldn't be happening. None of these trials would have been happening. If I wasn't running, they wouldn't be happening.
Oh, so it's political. Well, last I checked, rich and white worked in our two-tier justice system, whether you're in the conservative country club or the liberal social club. But I get it. When you're accustomed to privilege, equality feels like oppression.